All right, folks, this is Pokey Do-Right, and I've been having a lot of people ask me, how is that peak doing? Well, I'm going to give you an update. Today is 7 months. Now listen to it. Very quiet. 7 months and one day that this unit has been in full-term 24-hour-a-day service, nonstop. It's sizable. It's quite a big unit. Very heavy, about 17 pounds, 18 pounds maybe. I'm not sure. I think the package was like 19 or 20 pounds with the cords in it. Comes with these cords here, right here. And they are quite sizable cables that come with this. They're about 28 inches long. I think they're just a hair over 2 feet. And as you can hear it, it just cycles as needed. It's always ran that way and it runs fine. It's a little dusty on the front there. It's down here in the third level basement, and so it stays cool and very cool and comfortable in here. I have this one line here. This one line goes all the way up. It's 14 gauge and goes up and feeds my double door refrigerator, which pulls about 1,000 watts and startup. And it cycles normal like any refrigerator. Doesn't behave odd. In fact, the cooling core has not increased its temperature on the compressor at all, which I was surprised with the modified. But this peak has a very strange modified behavior. It's kind of almost like it's trying to be a true sine wave. It's not. It's never going to be a true sine wave. But it has this really strange, instead of it just being a notch like that, you know, and then over the notch, and then over the notch, you know, past zero. It's got a very strange, where it comes off of zero and has a little tiny little notch, and then goes up to the square, notches over, comes down, has a tiny little notch, and then goes past zero. So it's a little bit weird, but the appliances seem to love it. Even my digital clocks, which never would run right on a modified, run perfect on this. So, as you can see, these are 10 gauge wire, and these run to a circuit that I drop down through the floor with some 10 gauge that feeds one complete room and all the lighting. All my entire lighting is, this is old 113 year old house. It has this 14 gauge line right here, and it is running straight up. And it is feeding a link outlet that's up on the other floor. And then I have this other 10 gauge wire over here. I think I might have got them backwards here. But I have this other 10 gauge. It runs over and it powers this little 7 cubic foot deep freeze. And then it runs upstairs. And upstairs it is running a Mitsubishi split 7200 BTU air conditioner that it's two pieces. It has a piece on the outside of the wall and a piece on the inside of the wall. And all together, I'm running about 2500 watts through this at any given time. And it has never barked. It's never faulted. It's never had a problem. I've got so many freaking batteries down here that, it's got lots of amps. So, and then this fan here, it only kicks on as it needs to. Right now, it's pulling right around probably 1500 watts. That's pretty consistent and hourly on it. And it's been 7 months, one day, since this thing has been installed. And honestly, I've never owned anything that I could just be willing to recommend to a friend. I mean, it's kind of rare. My turbines I would recommend because I get good service out of them. I got one 7 years old, you know. But there's your work zone, 3,000 watt. You can find them numerous places, I guess. I know I got these on Amazon delivered to my door for under $230. And I would not say that this thing here hasn't done its job. And it's doing a hell of a job. It comes with this remote, you see, this remote right here that plugs in. It comes with these cables. I mean, all these other inverter companies, you know, like Whistler and Cobra and all that. I mean, you got to spend another $40 for a set of cables like these. And look how big these damn, I got huge hands. Look how big these cables are. And they're a little over 2 feet. some of these came with a 15-foot cord, and some of these of this remote, and some of them came with a 20-foot. This one came with a 20-foot cord, and it just barely made it down here to where I'm at. And I would definitely recommend this Peak to someone. It is sizably, it's quite large. If you don't have room for something that's this freaking big, man, you know, you might not want to get it. They do make a 2,000 watt model. Sportsman's Guide or something has them for about $125. And I would, man, I tell you what, before you go to Harbor Freight or before you buy a Whistler or before you buy, check these things out. Electronics in them, I tore one completely apart, literally. brand new out of the box, there goes my warranty for it. And the Peaks have good warranties. But there goes my warranty for it. But I did tear it completely apart, and I did put it back together, and it does work fine. But I had to see what's in it. The boards are very thick. The materials are very heavy. HEC, Hyundai Electronics Corporation, and Daewoo, and all these other really, really high-dollar parts are in these Peaks. They are assembled, final assembly. That case and all some of this other stuff is Chinese. So they're assembled in Chinese, but a lot of their good hardware comes from Taiwan and Korea. So you can pretty much bet what you're getting is what you're paying for plus. All right, hope you do right. I'm out of here.